Hello all, I'm Viru from electronicsinnovation.com. I'm your host for this episode. In the previous episodes, we have talked about what is LoRa, LoRaWAN, history of LoRa, who invented it and how it works. Later in another video, we have developed point-to-point communication based LoRa transceivers with RFM95 module and ESP32 development kit. In continuation to that, today we are going to work on star topology-based LoRaWAN communication protocol. In LoRaWAN communication protocol, there will be LoRa End Nodes, LoRa Gateways, Network Servers and Application Servers. As a part of this tutorial, first we will set up this LPS8 gateway and register on the Things Network Server. Later we will develop LoRa End Node which can be activated on ABP mode with this RFM95 module and Arduino Uno to publish the message Hello Electronics Innovation World. As we are not using any sensors to monitor the real-time data, I am not going to set up any application server to visualize the real-time data. Maybe we can cover this part in later videos. For now, we will set up this LPS8 gateway and register on the Things Network server. Later we will develop a LoRa End Node which can be activated on ABP mode. So let's see how we can do that. The RFM95 module breakout PCBs which are being used in this tutorial are sponsored and manufactured by PCBware.com. I would like to take a moment and thank PCBware.com for sponsoring the video. PCBware.com has been an essential company that supports makers like me around the world building professional PCB projects. They also support some of your favorite YouTubers with their projects. Without PCBware, some of the best projects posted online every day wouldn't be existing or not available. I am feeling grateful to thank PCBWay in this way for everything they are doing for the maker community. PCBWay.com is an online PCB manufacturing enterprise which provides all services you need to make hardware for your IoT or embedded devices. If you have similar requirement, do check out their website for more details. They have offers also. The link is in the description below. Recently, I bought this gateway from Dragino for my LoRa development work. I have been using this gateway for last 3 months. It's a plug-and-play gateway with very simple configurations. I am happily using this amazing product from Dragino and haven't encountered any significant issues. In this video, I'll let you know how to set up and configure this gateway to communicate with LoRa End Nodes in India allowed LoRa frequency 865 to 867 MHz and transfer the received data to the Things Network server. It's one of my favorite LoRaWAN gateways from Dragino which is named LPS8. LPS8 represents LoRaWAN Pico Station of 8 channels. The LPS8 is an open source 8-channel LoRaWAN gateway. It lets you bridge LoRa wireless network to an IP network via Wi-Fi or Ethernet. The LPS8 uses a Semtech packet forwarder and is fully compatible with LoRaWAN protocol. It includes an SX1308 LoRa concentrator which provides 10 programmable parallel demodulation paths. It can handle up to 1000 LoRa end nodes from different suppliers. If we look at the physical appearance, it has an antenna to receive the LoRa packets in 8 channels. On top of the module, we got 4 status LEDs. 1. Power LED. This red LED will be solid on if the device is properly powered. Second one, LoRa LED. The RGB LED blink green when the LoRaWAN module starts or transmit a packet. Third one, system LED. This RGB LED will show different colors in different states. A solid blue will be glown if the device alive with LoRaWAN server connection. A blinking blue will happen if the device has internet but there is no LoRaWAN connection or device in booting stage. A solid red will be happen if the device doesn't have any internet connection. Fourth one, Ethernet LED. This LED shows the Ethernet interface connection status. On the front side, it has an USB Type-C port for input power with specifications DC 5 volts and 2 amperes. Also, it has an Ethernet port, USB host port and a toggle button to reset to factory default settings. On the sides of the gateway, it doesn't have anything. At bottom of the gateway, it has LoRa Pico Station information like model LPS8, frequency band 865 or 868, serial number and the Wi-Fi MAC address of the device. That's all about LPS8 gateway physical observation. Let us power up the gateway and set up. There are 3 different ways to access and configure the LPS8.
Connect via Wi-Fi. The LPS8 is configured as Wi-Fi access point by factory default. You can access and configure the LPS8 after connecting to its Wi-Fi network. Second one, connect via Ethernet with DHCP IP from router. Connect the LPS8 Ethernet port to router and LPS8 can obtain IP address from router. You can access and configure the LPS8 by finding that IP in the router management portal. Third one, connect via Ethernet by directly interfacing with laptop. Connect LPS8 Ethernet port to your PC. It has a fallback IP address on its WAN port. You can access and configure the LPS8 by using the fallback IP address. I'll choose the first one as it is the simplest way to access and configure the LPS8 gateway. At the first boot of LPS8, it will auto-generate Wi-Fi access point called Dragino-something with password Dragino plus Dragino. Connect to the access point by entering the password. Now open your favorite browser and enter the following IP address 10.130.1.1. You will see the login interface of LPS8 as shown here. The account details for web login are username root, password Dragino. Enter the credentials and hit submit. This is the homepage of LPS8. Here you can see the network connection status of different environments, like whether the LPS8 is connected to the internet or not. If yes, the connection medium is what, whether it is Wi-Fi or Ethernet, the status of the LoRaWAN connection, LoRa connection and the access point connection. Now the LPS8 doesn't have any internet connection. So let us configure the LPS8 as Wi-Fi client by providing the Wi-Fi credentials. Go to the network, then click on Wi-Fi. We have to configure the Wi-Fi WAN client settings. Click on the Wi-Fi survey and find your Wi-Fi and select it. Then enter the password. In my case, it is subscribe, so enter the same. You also subscribe to the channel if you like the content I am providing here. In that way, you can motivate me to work hard and provide you the best content every time. Then check this enable Wi-Fi client option and click on save and apply. If you get the following response, you made it. Now uncheck the above enable Wi-Fi access point option and click on save and apply button. Now the access point will be removed and the LPS8 will directly connect to the configured Wi-Fi network if and only if you provide the right credentials. In case if you provide the wrong credentials, you have to connect to the LPS8 in other two methods. Because we have disabled the access point, we will no longer be able to communicate with LPS8 over Wi-Fi access point. If you provide the right credentials and the LPS8 connected to the network, we can communicate to our Wi-Fi. Let's see how we can do it. First, connect to the same network. Log in to the router management page and search for device named Dragino-something. As you can see here, our gateway successfully connected to the router and allocated with following IP address. Copy this address and paste on the new tab. Then add port 8000 and hit enter. The same page will appear here. Now you can see access point is disabled and rest of the networks are connected. Now let's configure the LoRa frequency. Go to the LoRa and click on the LoRa option. Select the right frequency plan. I am from India, so I choose the IN865 to 867 MHz band, which is allowed in my country. Select the frequency allowed in your country only. If you want, you can also provide the GPS coordinates of location where it is. Then click on save and apply. That's it. Now the gateway is configured to receive the LoRa packets on 865 to 867 MHz. Now go to the LoRaWAN option and click on LoRaWAN. Every LPS8 has a unique gateway ID. This ID can be found on this page. This is our gateway ID. Open a new tab and visit the Things Network platform. If you are a first time user, sign up by providing all required details. Then log into the platform using the same credentials. Then come to home page. Click on the username and select console. The things network has divided all countries into three different clusters and assigned different server addresses. Select a cluster to start adding devices and gateways. I am from India. I'll choose Europe 1 or EU 1. Now log into the Things stack using the Things ID and then click on Continue. This is the homepage of Things stack Community Edition. Here we have two options. One, create an application. Second one, register a gateway. Choose to register a gateway. This is the gateway registration page. The owner will be selected by default. If you want, you can change it from here. Enter the gateway ID. This can be alphanumeric string, but only lowercase alphabets are allowed. Then enter the gateway UI. This can be found on the gateway LoRaWAN page. Copy that address and paste it here. If the gateway ID is in lowercase alphabets, that will be automatically converted to the uppercase letters. Then give a name for your gateway. This can be anything. Uppercase alphabets are allowed here. If you want, you can also add a description for the gateway. Then just remember the gateway server address. We will use this in the next steps. Keep all these selections default. Select the frequency plan. The frequency plan of the gateway should be entered here. Our plan is 865 to 867 MHz. So same plan was selected here. Then click on Create Gateway. That's it. The gateway has been created successfully and the status of the gateway showing disconnected for now, because a couple of configurations are pending. Now go to the gateway management page. Select service provider, the Things Network V3, and select the server address eu.cloud.thethings.network. I have asked you to remember the server address, right? The same address should be selected here. Then click on Save and Apply. Then come to the Things Network page and reload it. As you can see here, the status of the gateway turned to connected. This means now our LPS8 gateway is able to communicate with the Things Network server over Wi-Fi. The live data log also showing the same. It is created and then connected. Just now, the gateway also sent the gateway status. All gateway event details are provided in this data packet. So that's it for this tutorial. We have successfully configured the 8-channel LPS8 gateway to communicate with the Things Network server. Also registered and activated the LoRaWAN Pico station on the Things Network server. Now we have to develop a LoRa End Node with RFM95 module and Arduino Uno. But due to the long length of the video, I have decided to make another video for that. You can find that video link in the description or just follow the above I button. Let's meet in that video. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more interesting videos on LoRa communication. See you soon. Bye-bye.